Oscar Bevis for IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here at the Hennessy Sports Show at York Hall. I'm joined by Mr. Shaquille Day. How are you, sir? You all right?
I'm good, thanks. I'm very good, thanks.
First things first, you were meant to fight Maidstone.
Yeah.
Obviously an MTK card there. Didn't quite happen. Do you want to just tell us what
was behind it? I got an injury through the camp, and then I found out I had another injury as well. So I had a shoulder injury and then a calf tear as well. So I had two injuries that just I couldn't get around, and they were, how do you explain, like they were doing what they were doing to like get, so it was like something on my mind that was holding me back, that's the word, that was holding me back to enough to not allow me to fight. So I just thought better off not going in there 50% and at all, and then blaming it on that at the end. So just had to let them know that I couldn't make the fight.
Obviously disappointing from your perspective.
Oh, yeah, 100%, but yeah,
sort of rescheduled, looking for the same fight again, or
yeah, potentially, yeah. I'll just see what happens now, because obviously it opens up the, because Jezzy's fighting next weekend, next Friday,
right?
And then we'll see what happens with that, and then see what happens if it opens it up in the new year to fight for something different and move on from the southern area, and then go from there to see what happens.
Do you still looking to perhaps box once more with the southern area?
Yeah, potentially, yeah. Defend it would be nice, 100%, because then it just lets people know who I really am, and winning and staying current with the southern area, and then showing that I can be in these title fights or whatever else. So that's what it's for.
Former southern area champion at your weight as well, Samuel Antwi.
Yeah.
Fighting tonight.
Yeah, I see him.
Maybe get that one on.
But he's cool, man. Sam's cool. But I haven't got no beef with him. But if that does come along, I'll have a go with him. So yeah, I don't mind. But if it's something for like an English, something worthy, a good title to fight for, then yeah, 100%.
Welterweight's got quite a couple names domestically. Do you sort of want to break down the scene for me and think that, in terms of sort of next year, where you could be looking at going as well? What sort of guys do you think you could be in the mix with?
I could be in the mix with, some of the ratings in like the Boxing Monthly stuff, I'm still top 10 or whatever else. So I will fight anyone that in the top 10 for something other than my gym partners like Garton and whatever else. Yeah. So, I'll fight anyone. Those sort of titles will come along, and fights will come along in time. They have to come, because it's the top 10 you're looking to be best of. So potentially for me, really, I want to fight for the English next. That's what you want to do.
Fair enough. Sam Gilley, I think he might have dropped down to welter for his last fight.
Yeah.
I mean, he mentioned that he would like to fight you, and he was actually going to go to watch you in Maidstone. I remember him saying that when he won on the Golden Contract card. That for the English title?
That'd be a good fight for an English title. Wicked, 100%. Yeah, 100%. Yeah, Sam's a good kid. I've seen him seen him fight and whatever else. I've seen him in the change room other than that, but I haven't really sparred him or nothing, but it'd be a good fight.
Okay, and you mentioned your gym mate, Johnny Garton. I'm going to get my hands on him in a minute and ask him the question that everyone sort of wants to know about, where him and Conor Benn is, where that might stand. If that was a fight that was to come off, just talk to me a little bit about what you think would happen. I can imagine you'd be back in Johnny, but
100% back in John. But for me personally, I feel like he's too experienced and too tough for that. Conor Benn ain't got what John's got heart-wise and determination-wise. You can't really, once John's in the flow and got it going, you can't really stop that. His determination and his art, and he is unbelievably powerful. He doesn't seem it, but he's got a set of heavy hands on him. So you got to watch out for that alone. So for me, it would be a John win all day long.
Okay. Thank you very much, Shaquille Day, for speaking to IFL TV. And when you are next out, whether it be for the Southern area or not, I'm sure we'll catch you then.
100%.